Hello, I'm Jürgen Bellmann from Sophistic, and I want to show you our Eshto bridge design.
Please also look to our introduction video, Bridge Design. In this video, we use this little bridge, where we have a superstructure section as a beam, a tendon, and a typical support condition. The construction stages are analyzed with the construction stage manager, but we do not have real construction stages here. We use the CSM mainly to analyze creep and shrinkage. If we look to our construction sequence, we see that we only have dead load, pre-stress and creep. We have dead load, pre-stress and creep, while creep can be divided in creep 1 up to traffic opening and creep 1 and creep 2 for checks at time infinite. We collect all this together in GPC or dead load, pre-stress, creep. A very important thing is that these forces act on different cross-section stages. We can see this better on a steel composite section. Maybe the first dead load of the steel acts only on the steel, and the additional dead load will act on the composite section. Also, creep and shrinkage is very important because maybe the shrinkage of the concrete deck slab will get a tension in the concrete, but will also produce simultaneously a compression in the steel. These inner stress states integrated give a bending moment and normal force of zero, but we have inner stresses. The same happens in a pre-stressed beam, where creep and shrinkage in the concrete leads to a loss of pre-stress in the tendon, and so we also get an inner stress state due to creep and shrinkage. As we have inner stresses, we cannot superpose only the forces in maxima. Now let's have a look to the variable actions. This is mainly live load, braking, water and settlement effects, wind effects and temperature. They all act on the final section, and so they can be presuperposed in maxima. In the presuperposition of the variable actions, these actions are combined in maxima with the individual factors of the Eshto table 3411. And the result is stored in a so-called container, strength 1 and strength 2, and so on. We implemented an input that is similar to this table 3.411. As you see here, our program CSM, you can define a combination where you can use this strength 1, 2, 3, 4 combinations and define the individual safety factors, maybe for live load, braking, wind and temperature. They are then stored in a container strength 1, strength 2, strength 5 and so on. The main program in bridge design is our beam design program AQB. This now collects from the construction stage manager the dead load pre-stress creep effect and adds the variable actions with the container strength 1, for example. The MAX-D tells the program to also include the load safety factors. The safety factors from the construction stages come with the literal D, maybe 1.25 for dead load DC and 1.50 for DW. These safety factors must be defined in our program Sophie Load, maybe action D1 for the structural dead load DC and D3 for the wearing surface and utilities. Please remember, all variable load cases act on the final section, and so these forces can be pre-superposed in maxima. While the load cases from the construction stage analysis may act on different cross-section stages and may have inner stresses of creep and shrinkage. Now let's have a look at a typical service check. Here we have also the GPC load cases from the Construction Stage Manager and a container, now set one, that has the container of the service effects. Now we make a combination with MAX in AQB, telling the program not to use safety factors for the permanent actions. The variable actions may have the safety factors already in the container. But don't worry, it is not necessary that you learn how to write these AQB input. How to define this in Sophistic? We first define our superpositioning in a first CSM task, defining the combinations, strength and service, with the safety factors, and tell the program to create the containers. Then we have a little input maybe for a CSM design on ultimate limit, and we tell the program to use the combinations 1, 2, 3 for this ultimate limit design. Or if we make a service design, we just tell the program, please make a design for sigma stresses with the combinations 11 and 12. Looking to the SLS stress results, we now get a picture of the nonlinear concrete stresses in service 1 and in service 2. And afterwards, we get also a plot for the stress of all required services. Please remember that these stresses are calculated on the cracked section, so a nonlinear work law for the concrete and a cracked concrete. Due to cracking, of course, the tension in the reinforcement and the tendons, of course, increases. We see here the nonlinear steel stress of all required services. We have prepared 4 different examples. You will find it in the csm.dat folder English More. The first is the CSM31 Design Eshto Bridge. You can find this with inch values and with metric values, so meter and kilonewton. There is also an example for a quad shell design and a file for a stage design using this Eshto technique.
So thank you for listening and goodbye.